What's up, YouTube? I'm Evan Thorpe. This is Stephen Ruiz, and today we'll be breaking down and previewing the AFC South. And let's start with the team in Duval. Jacksonville Jaguars, they won 10 games last year. Vegas has them winning 9. Do you see this team reaching 9 wins, or do you see them falling off from where they were last year?
I think they'll get to 9 or 10 wins, but that's not really the goal with this team. The goal is now the Super Bowl after what happened last year, and I don't see them reaching that goal. I don't really like what they did in the offseason, re-signing Blake Bortles, kind of locking themselves into Bortles for the next 2 years at least. So I'm going to say they're a 10-6 kind of team, which is kind of a disappointment with all this hype surrounding them.
All right, next up we have a team that also went to the playoffs, Tennessee Titans. 9 wins last year, Vegas has them projected for 8. Do you see this team improving?
Yeah, I think they get better just because the coaching staff is better now. Or at least it should be better. We don't know what to expect out of a first-year coach in Mike Vrabel. But as long as it's not Mike Mularkou, who has had a playbook from 1995, and the defense wasn't much better either. And they added pieces, so combine the pieces they added with the coaching change, I think they're an 11-win team.
Okay. Next up, we have the Colts. This team had 4 wins last year, but they're getting a key piece back into that offense, and Vegas has them winning 6.5 games. What do you see of the Colts next year?
Yeah, I think 6.5 is a low number. If they won 4 with luck, and they had a bunch of fourth quarter leads last year that they blew, you add a quarterback into that mix, maybe a better coaching staff that will close those games out. 6.5 is way too low for me. This is an 8-8 win team at the least. And if Andrew Luck returns to form as he was playing when we last saw him in 2016, this is potentially a wild card contender in this division.
All right, so another team that had quarterback issues last year, the Texans, won 4 games but had a strong showing from their rookie quarterback, Deshaun Watson. And Vegas has them basically almost competing with the Jaguars with 8.5 wins. Is that a reach, or can you see this Texans team winning 9 games next year?
I think it's a big reach just because there's so many injury concerns. Start with Deshaun Watson, who's torn 2 ACLs now, 1 in college, 1 last year. J.J. Watt can't seem to stay healthy any year. Jadeveon Clowney always has injury concerns. Whitney Mercilus got hurt last year. That's the core of the defense. So I'm going to go under. Even if they stay healthy, I'm not convinced that Deshaun Watt's going to be able to replicate what he did last year. He was really like a volatile player last year. It was either a deep bomb, big play, or he was throwing into coverage and it was almost picked off. He caught a lot of lucky breaks where defenders dropped interceptions, and he really wasn't that accurate either.
All right, let's go into some rapid-fire questions. First off, who had the best offseason in this division?
I'm going to say the Titans. We already talked about the coaching change. Then you add Deion Lewis. That's a playmaker who can play running back. He can split out wide and be a receiver. And then their draft was great. They added Rashawn Evans, who's a playmaking linebacker from Alabama. Their defense is just better all around, and the offense should be better with the coaching change.
All right, so who had the worst offseason in this division?
This was a tough pick for me, but I'm going to go with the Jaguars just because of the Bortles contract that closes the Super Bowl window for this team. They're now locked into him for 2 years, and it's hard to keep a defense together, so you don't know how long they're going to keep Ramsey and Malik Jackson and Calais Campbell together.
All right, so who is on a hot seat in this division?
You have to go with the default choice, and that's Bill O'Brien. We don't see progress from Deshaun Watson, and there's high expectations for Deshaun Watson, so if the offense isn't clicking, they're going to blame it on the play caller, who is Bill O'Brien.
All right, who is the rookie to watch in this division?
It's a boring pick. It's an offensive lineman, but I'm going to go with Quentin Nelson just because the Colts need to do a way better job of protecting Andrew Luck, and he's the left guard, so he's going to stop that interior pressure. And he's supposedly one of the best offensive line prospects in a decade, so he's going to be one to watch.
All right, and what's the X factor, the biggest X factor in this division?
It's the health of the quarterbacks. I'm going to say Andrew Luck and Deshaun Watson. If both of those guys stay healthy and play as well as they've played in the past, maybe both these teams challenge for the division. If they don't, if they get hurt again, then both of these teams are at the bottom of the standings.
All right, with that, who wins this division?
I'm going to pick the Titans. I'm going to say they dethrone the Jaguars. They beat them twice last year. They swept them. They got better. I think they only lost the division by 1 game last year, and they've made drastic improvements all over the roster. I think the Titans take the division.